गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस न्यूमेरिकल रिलेटेड टू द टर्बुलेंट फ्लो। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल नोट डाउन द न्यूमेरिकल। वाटर एट 20 डिग्री सेल्सियस एंटर्स अ 2 सेंटीमीटर डायमीटर ट्यूब विथ अ वेलोसिटी ऑफ 1.5 मीटर per second. The tube is maintained at 100 degree Celsius. Find the tube length required to heat the water to a temperature of 60 degree Celsius. Use properties of fluid, Prandtl number 4.31, density 992.2 kg per meter cube, Cp 4174 joule per kg Kelvin, value of nu 0.659 × 10⁻⁶ meter square per second. So this is the given data and they are asking to find the length of tube. First of all, we are going to write down the given data. Okay, so they have mentioned water at 20 degree Celsius. So they have given the value of Ti is 20 degree Celsius. Next they have mentioned a 2 cm diameter. Diameter they have given, D is equal to 2 cm. So we are going to convert it. Next, velocity is 2 cm diameter tube with a velocity of 1.5 meter per second. So value of V 1.5 meter per second. The tube is maintained at 100 degree Celsius. So next, find the length of the tube required to heat the water to a temperature 60 degree Celsius. So they have mentioned and properties they have mentioned PR 4.31, density 992.2 kg per meter cube. Next, Cp 4174 joule per kg Kelvin. Then Kf value they have given 0.634 watt per meter Kelvin. Nu value they have given 0.659 × 10⁻⁶ meter square per second. So they are asking you to find out the length of the tube, and we know that in this numerical, suppose we have to find the length of the pipe, then we have to find the amount of heat supplied, then we have to use the area in that formula. So our formula is Q is equal to H A delta T, which is T S minus t infinity. So in this formula, q is required, h is required, ts, t infinity is required, and in this area we are getting the length. So we are writing the formula h a, for a we can substitute pi d l, circumferential surface area, which is pi d l. Now, so in this way we can calculate, but before that we require the value of q. How we are going to find out the value of q? Q is equal to mcp delta t. Here we are taking 0 minus tr. Okay, so in this way we can calculate the value of q. But while calculating value of q, we are required the value of m, cp, to, and tr. Okay, so mass they are not mentioned, so for that they are giving you the rho a v. So we are going to substitute here. Okay, mass we can calculate, rho value they have given. Okay, then v they have given, so we can substitute here. But here area is different and here area is different. Here area we can take pi by 4 d square, and for that area they have given the diameter. So here you can easily get the value of q. Next, this first unknown we are getting q. Next, second h we have to find. So for calculating this h, we are going to be use the relation nu is equal to 0.023 r a raised to 0.8 and pr raised to 0.4. So here nu is equal to hd by k 0.023 r a raised to 0.8 and pr raised to 0.4. So in this way we can calculate h. But whenever we are using this equation, when there is a flow is the turbulent. So first of all we have to find out whether the flow is turbulent or laminar. Okay, so for that purpose you have to calculate the Reynolds number. R is equal to rho vd divided by mu, or we can say vd divided by nu, because nu value we have mentioned here, so we can use this formula also. Okay, so one by one we are going to solve this. First of all we have to calculate the mean temperature of water. So mean temperature of water is Pr plus Qo divided by 2, which is Pr 20 plus Qo 60 divided by 2. So mean temperature of water we are getting 40 degree Celsius. Okay, next we are going to calculate Reynolds number. So in this Reynolds number V is 1.5 diameter, we have converted 0.02 nu value they have given in the numerical, 0.02 659 इंटू 10^2 माइनस 6. So after solving this equation on the calculator, we are getting Reynolds number is 45.523 into 10^3. 45.523 into 10^3. So definitely this Reynolds number is greater than 4000. So the flow is turbulent. So we are writing here turbulent flow. As this is greater than 4000. Okay? So here you are getting turbulent flow. So you are going to use this equation. Mu is equal to 0.023 RE^0.8 into PR^0.4. So for mu, you can substitute HD by K. So you can easily get the value of H. So H into diameter 0.02, value of K they have given 0.634 into 0.023 into RE, just we have calculated 45.523 into 10^3 rest to 0.8 into PR value they have given 4.31 into point rest to 0.4. So we are known in value of H. So you can easily solve this on the calculator and you are getting value of H is 6968.875 watt per meter square Kelvin. So value of H you are getting. So value of Q next you are going to find MCP delta T Q minus T R. So Q value of rho, it is 992.2. Next area that is 5 by 4, d square means 0.02 square into value of CP 4174 into TO minus TI is 60 minus 20. So you are going to solve this total equation. So you are getting value of Q is 78.0643 into 10^3 watt. Okay, so you are getting value of Q. Once you know the value of H, once you know the value of Q, you are going to substitute in this equation. So Q 78.0643 into 10^2 minus the value of H 6968.875 into pi into d 0.02 L we have to find, and Ts minus T infinity is 100 minus 40. So after solving this, you are only up to is the L. So after solving this information on the calculator, you are getting the value of L is 2.9713 meter. So in this way, you are getting the length which is they have required for the pipe. So once again, I am repeating, this is the numerical related with the turbulent flow. So while solving this numerical, they have given the data, TI they have given 20 degree Celsius, diameter they have mentioned, then velocity they have given, next surface temperature they have mentioned, TO they have given 60 degree Celsius, Prandtl number, density, Cp, K and nu, these values they have mentioned in the numerical. And we have to find the value of L, and we have the formula for finding the value of L, that is Q is equal to HA into delta T. Okay, this is the convective heat transfer coefficient, so that's why this is the formula. But in this formula, area we are considering is the pi dL, because this is the convective heat transfer coefficient. So pi dL area we are considering, and in this pi dL the length is the present, and this L we have to calculate. Now after seeing this modified formula, you require value of Q, value of H, TS and T infinity. TS and T infinity they have already mentioned in the given data. Diameter also they have mentioned in the data. Only we have to require to find the value of Q and value of H. And for calculating the value of Q, it is heat transferred by that water, which is mCp delta T, we can calculate. So Q is equal to mCp delta T. Mass is not mentioned in this numerical, so we are converting the mass, that is the rho A V. So we can substitute all the values in this equation, and we are getting the value of Q over there. Okay, next, to find the value of H, we know that for the turbulent flow we are using the relation NV is equal to 0.023 into R raised to 0.8 into P raised to 0.4. So in this equation, NV is equal to HD by K, and here we are getting the convective transfer coefficient. So H value we have to find. So diameter they have mentioned, K they have given, Reynolds number only we have to find, and Prandtl number they have also given. But when we are using this equation, when we know that this flow is the turbulent, so first of all we have to determine this is which type of flow. So we have formula R is equal to rho Vd divided by mu, or Vd by nu. Nu is given in the numerical, diameter is given, velocity is given. So we can easily find the Reynolds number. And after observing the Reynolds number, we are getting that this number is greater than the 4000. So the flow is the turbulent flow. So we are getting the turbulent flow. Also we have find the mean temperature, that is mean temperature is the 40, because here we have to T infinity is the mean temperature we have to substitute. So inlet temperature and outlet temperature they have mentioned in the numerical. So by using that we can calculate the mean temperature, which is 40. After that we have decided the Reynolds number. If the Reynolds number is greater than 4000, we are using this relation. By using this relation we are finding the convective heat transfer coefficient. After that we are finding the heat transfer by using the relation mCp delta T. As mass is not mentioned here, we are substituting the rho A V. Next, Q is equal to HA delta T, convective heat transfer coefficient, and here area is the pi d L. They are asking you to find the length of the tube. So we are substituting the all the values, only unknown is the length, and you are getting the length, which is 2.9713 meter. So this is the today's numerical. This is all about the टुडे सेशन। थैंक यू वेरी मच।